It's time for 28mm World War II action. Will you recreate history or reshape it your way? On the Bolt Action Hub at beastsofwar.com. Anime cyberpunk style meets skirmish combat in Infinity. Experience 8 high-tech factions and fight to control the human sphere at the Infinity Hub on beastsofwar.com.
Hi everybody and welcome to Let's Play Undercity. Guys, welcome to the show.
Yeah!
I'm joined by Lance and Lloyd.
Hey-o.
Because it's always fun to get everybody in for a game once in a while. This particular one I learned to play while I was at Lock and Load Outpost over in Manchester, which was a good time.
You got time to go dungeon delving?
Oh yeah.
You were supposed to be filming and you got time to dungeon delve?
Yeah, we found a little bit of space and the press gangers over there were kind enough to teach myself and Ben how to play the game. So, you know who you are, thank you
Lucky
very much.
Sods.
All right, well, I also got to play the game at the weekend, which has sort of refreshed me on the rules a little bit. If I get stuff wrong, feel free to hang me, because I should know this by now.
You should.
You're setting yourself up for failure here, Justin.
We'll see.
Come on, run us noobs through it.
We are a dungeon delving party in the Iron Kingdoms,
yes.
And this is the first mission. So, our mission today is that we have to get to this dead body and get the intelligence that he has on him. He was our contact, but he unfortunately died.
What's he got? He's got like secret plans.
Secret plans, yes.
Secret like death.
So how do we get them?
Super secret epic plans.
He's got the Death Star plans.
Yeah, but he has them written down.
All right,
they're in a note in his pocket. We have to go and actually search the dead body.
Okay? What? Right. He's dead.
He's dead.
He's dead.
What sort of contact is he if he's dead?
You can see he's dead by his little dead counter.
He's not very good.
Yeah.
This is him.
Well, more to the point, actually,
by four thugs.
I think Lance hit the nail on the head. Why is our secret contact writing the secret plans down on a bit of paper for the not so secret thugs? Yeah, in fact,
to find out.
Look at it. He's there. He's surrounded by thugs. How do we even know these papers are going to be there by the time we get there?
Because that's the mission.
Hold on. Maybe they're illiterate. We may get lucky. Could we not have sent a courier, though?
Right. Anyway, we each have a character to play within this game,
okay.
Right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So for myself, I am playing Canis Gromley, the Gunmage Duelist. A very, very handy little character, which is going to be running around and shooting everything. Lance, who are you playing?
I am playing Gardic Stonebrow, Trollkin Warrior.
Let's have a look at him. Okay, so this guy looks to be the tank of the group. He's got a big axe, big shield, big health, big armor. This should be fun. You're basically the steel wall to stop us all getting murdered in the Underdark, okay? Lloyd, who are you?
I am Milo Bogus. I think is how you say this.
No. With that piece of artwork?
Ah, I am Milo Bogus.
What's he doing?
Bane. I don't know. Sounded like Bane.
Yeah. Look at him. Bane. He's wearing
the
Bane mask.
That's the worst Bane. You have to throw a verse for a better thought.
Perhaps you should shoot a man before throwing him out of a plane.
Anyway, Lloyd.
Perhaps we shouldn't do this joke because we're not very good at it.
That was horrendous. Anyway, Lloyd, you are playing the Cutthroat Alchemist.
Yeah!
So you're going to be throwing grenades everywhere.
Watch this space.
Watch,
so you're just
the grenades
a chemist.
Fly through the air.
Yeah.
All right, well.
I'm here to see to all your needs.
Yeah.
Let's get stuck into the game and I'll teach you guys how to play, okay?
Okay.
So at the beginning of the game round, which is once each of us have taken a turn, we get an event card, okay?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So our first event is Ominous Silence. So there are no special effects this turn, but it's a red turn. So the red minions are going to be taking priority in certain aspects of the game, okay?
Well, that was a boring start to the game.
And
nothing happens.
If everything's quiet, I'm suspicious, but I'm not getting shot at.
It's the silence before the storm. That's what it is.
Now, the game runs on initiative, so I'm going first because I have an initiative of 15.
Wow.
What's your initiative?
I'd be initiative something 12.
12? Lance?
I'd rather not talk about it.
Come on.
I've barely made it through the door with initiative 3.
Don't worry, though. You're big.
I'm big, but that doesn't mean to say I can't move fast.
Well, we'll see. So, I get to go first. So, at the start of every single player's turn, you have to spawn a villain, okay? So, the way it works is, you'll roll a black dice to actually choose which minion it is, and a white dice to choose which location it is. This is actually marked out with these little tokens here, and that actually tells you which of your guys is going to be going. So you have crossbow thugs and you have sword thugs, okay?
Yeah, and does each of the dice represent something on the table?
Yes, so the white dice is representing 1, 2, 3, they come in here, 4, 5, 6, they come in over here, okay?
Yeah.
So there's two entrances to this. As you move through and play the next missions and stuff, you'll get more places that they can come in from, okay?
So this would be scenario one from the book, I take it?
Yes, this is the very first scenario. This is your training mission, okay? This is the simplest thing. We cannot mess this up.
We're pretending to be, what is it, boffins and getting the Death Star plans?
Yeah.
I don't want to die. I'm not a boffin.
Is it boffin?
Boffin.
I keep saying boffins. Oh, I'm a boffin. I'm quite smart. I'm going to go get these Death Star plans.
Right, anyway, I'm going to roll black dice to see what minion it is. Okay, so it's a 6, and he's coming in to location 2. The 6, that's going to be a crossbow thug. There are currently more red thugs than there are blue thugs, so the red thug will come in. And he was coming in right over here. Now, one important thing. You see these squares? We can only have 7 miniatures in them at a time. A large base miniature like yourself, Lance, you count as 2 miniatures, okay?
How dare you?
You're 2.
Oi, none of that. But anyway, so that is the spawn phase taken care of, right?
Yes.
I now get to do my actions. So you have a couple of different options for whenever you're moving.
Okay.
You can go on hold,
yeah,
which means you can take aim shots with your ranged weapons. You can move, which allows you to move 1 square, so 1 square on the table. So if I was moving, I'd go 1.
Yes.
Or you can charge, which allows you to go 2,
yes,
and get into melee if you're actually meeting someone at the end of that.
But are you giving up something if you move 2 squares instead of 1?
If you move 2 squares instead of 1, you can't do things like shooting or searching.
But you can be stabby stabby.
Yes, yes, because this is going to be most useful for
Lance. Can I be stabby stabby or shooty shooty before I move?
No, you have to move, then do your action, okay?
Movement first.
So, for myself, I'm actually going to play a feat card. Now, feat cards are the little heroic extras you can do. So the one I'm going to do is called Hoof It. So this actually lets me move an extra square and still be able to shoot at the end of it. Now, the important thing with these feat cards is you start out with 3 of them. So, Lloyd, bring this up for me.
Cool.
So, you start off with 3 of them, and you can spend as many as you want in a turn, but you only generate 1 new one every turn. So you're kind of on a resource management, balancing act here. So I'm playing Hoof It to get me an extra bit of movement. And from over here, that'll allow me to go 1-2 and still take a shot at one of these guys. However, I'm actually going to play another card, which is called Brace Shot. So this allows me to play this card to aim even if I moved. So right. I'm getting to move 2 and I'm getting to aim. What aiming's going to do is for whenever you're actually doing your shooting, the entire system is based off 2d6 plus your stat.
Yeah.
If you aim, you get to boost it, which gives you an extra dice, making it 3 dice. So with it being a red turn, I'm going to target the red swordsman over here and try and take him out, okay?
Yeah.
So I'll roll the dice, and his defense is 12. So I've got 10 there, plus my accuracy of 5 on my weapon, the ACC. That puts it to 15, so I'm over his defense,
yeah,
which means I've done the damage. Now, because I'm a gun mage, I get rune shots. So every time I shoot, I get to give these an ability. Now, obviously, this time I would be going for Brutal, but I should really be calling that before I roll to hit, okay? So Brutal allows me to boost my damage.
Yes.
So my power is 8, his armor is 12, so I am looking for 5 or more, because you have to meet defense, but you have to beat the armor, okay?
Okay.
If that you should say be pretty so. Easy.
5 or more, oh, easily done.
So, look at that!
Wow.
To the head, he is dead.
That's a major overkill there, Justin.
So the great thing is now, we get XP for every point of damage we do.
Oh, what's that for?
That is for whenever you're coming to your later mission. So we would complete this mission, hopefully succeed, gain XP, and then we're allowed to buy abilities from this, which is the ability deck.
There's a progression system.
Yeah, so you actually get better and stuff. So like this one, cost 2 XP, duelist training. If you hold or walk, you can make both melee and ranged attacks in the same turn.
Sweet.
Cool. So basically, my character suddenly becomes very, very nasty because she can actually charge, shoot, and basically do damage.
I'm excited about this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think because of this feat system, this game could be head and feet above some others. No?
That was cheesy.
No. Oh, move on then.
That was as cheesy as toe cheese.
Make him
right. My action phase is now complete, so we move on to the villain action, right?
Yeah.
So the villains are going to get to do some stuff now.
Oh.
Now, so this one is called Azure Assault. So activate up to 2 blue villains closest to you. Target the one with the highest initiative. So you see at the bottom here, it tells you who the villains are going to target. So this is sort of like the brain of this game.
This don't sound good for you, Justin, because there's 2 blue guys here, and there you are, and you are the one with the highest initiative.
I am. So unfortunately, what's going to happen is
you're ducking open waters.
I'm going to open this guy, or activate this guy.
Open him up.
Yeah. He will actually activate, and on his card it tells you what he'll do. So, you see this bottom row here? This says that if he starts in the same square as a hero, he will attack. Here he will charge, and here he will run as fast as he can toward the nearest hero.
So he's going to be, what is he going to do then? Is he going to be stabby?
He's going to charge me.
Oh, he starts charging.
So he'll go, 1, 2, get into base with me, and he will attack.
Oh, now he's Mr. Stabby.
Now he's Mr. Stabby. So, the way this works is, Lance, if you want to grab 2 dice for me.
Now, why me?
Because anytime that a villain is doing a roll, it's always the player to your left. So
okay.
You would be technically to my left from here. So, you're going to roll his accuracy of 4 versus my defense of 13. Means you need 9 or more on 2 dice.
We can do it. We can do it. We can do it.
Don't do it.
Yes!
It.
Oh, that's a big roll.
Aye, but that, thankfully, is only to hit. Now we're on to damage. So he's power 8 versus my armor of 12.
It's Justin going 12.
Down. So I need 4 or more.
No, 5 or more because you have to beat armor.
Do it.
Okay. Average 7, so we can probably do it.
Yes. Oh, my goodness!
What the hell?
Double sixes!
Okay, so that is unfortunately a point of damage for me.
You've been a silly monkey.
Ow.
And rushed off into danger.
Mm-hmm. I didn't expect that.
Why are you being so aggressive?
Because I have to get to the dead body and search for the the thingy.
Dead body can
search
be a
for
trap.
The Death Star plans.
Search for Death Star plans, yes. Well, we're in a steampunk world, so it would actually be the Steam Star.
Right, so...
Okay.
Is that your turn?
That's my turnover.
Do you need to draw feat cards or anything like that?
Yes, at the end of my activation phase, I should have actually drawn one. So, Lucky Bullet and Point Blank. Not bad. Play this card to boost both the attacks and damage rolls of your ranged attack against a villain in your space.
I
still shoot someone.
I noticed you have 2 feat cards and we have 3.
Yes, I burnt 2 that turn, so I hoofed it.
Yeah.
And then I also used Brace Shot to give me an aim shot.
And is there a limit or can we use all 3 if
you
we
could
want?
Use all 3, but you're having to rebuild then.
Oh. Yeah.
So you always draw one card.
You always draw one card, yeah. And if you draw one card and you already have 3, you have to discard one of those 4.
And do I have to draw a card
regardless?
You have
to draw a card regardless.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
Yeah, so it kind of shows that it is cycling through. You're trying to plan out what you're doing a little bit.
Okay.
You know? Yeah. So, that's me done. Next initiative up is Lloyd.
Yeah!
So, roll for some villains for us. Black for type, white for location.
Okay. Black, I got a 4. Location, okay. I got a 1.
Okay. Yep, so it's going to be red priority. So 4 was the type, so it's going to be one of these guys. It's going to be a red one because it's a red round,
yeah.
And he's coming in at location 1, which is over here.
Over there.
So now you get to activate.
I get to activate.
Yes.
What are you going to do, Bane?
I'm all the way up. Well, I'm not really sure, but I haven't had it. Forget that. This is juicy looking, right? And I'll tell you why this looks juicy to me. Because I've got Air of Effect explosive grenades. I'm sitting reading this going, oh, sweet.
Yeah, so your AoE is going to hit automatically, but it does less damage than your acid vial.
Yeah, but I'm assuming that a regular thug isn't going to be that
They're
tough.
They're not that tough.
They're going to be a little bit on the squishy side. Right, let me move. So,
all right, so where are you going?
If I move to here, will I be able to see them?
What is your range?
Range 2.
1, 2. I would say from here, yes. You could.
Is there not going to be any line of sight issues or anything?
If you were here, I would say no, but because you're on sort of a straight diagonal from them, I'd say you could see into that reasonably well.
Because I do have a hoof it if you thought I needed to move further.
No, I'd say you're okay from here, because 1, 2, and you can see this front edge here. So you draw a
throw
line
into the farther wall.
There. Yeah, you can see
And if
that.
I went in there, would this stabby McStabby guy get a go at me?
Only if you were trying to step out from there. So. He has to activate to do damage in a square, but if you try and leave a square, he gets what's essentially called a free strike at you. You know, you're turning your back to him and he's going, nope, I'm going to put one in your back.
Okay.
Okay? So I would say you can move forward 1 and chuck your grenade and be in range, okay?
I'm going to move forward. I'm going to hoof it. I really want to get up there.
Okay.
I'm going to hoof it. I should be able to still attack these guys if I'm standing here, yeah?
No, because you're in combat then.
Oh, well then I'm not going to do that. So I'm going to move forward 1.
Okay.
And I'm going to throw a grenade 2.
Yep.
And it's going to be the explosive grenade because I've noticed my other acid attack is not an area of effect.
It's only single damage.
It's just like straight on you.
Yeah. So basically you use it on just
it's
a single
it's a smaller vial.
Okay. Right. So how do we do this then, Justin?
Okay. So basically you don't have to roll the hit because it's AoE.
Yeah.
But you do have to roll the damage. So each of these guys has armor 12. What's the power of your attack?
It'd be power 5.
Power 5. So 5 from 12.
7.
a 7, so you'll have to roll 8 or more on 2 dice.
8 or more.
Unless you have a way to boost it. Do you have anything that says
you
boost?
You do have
rolls?
Boost.
Oh, well, play this card to boost one of your rolls.
Yeah, so you could definitely kill
or
one
Or play
of them.
This card to reroll any number of dice from one of your attacks.
Yeah.
Or stats challenges. Do you have to play a feat before you would start doing stuff, or can you play a feat after you've decided you've to roll?
Not after you've rolled. I'd say you would play before you roll.
You think?
Well, I doubt it, because that wouldn't make sense. Is it play this card to reroll any number of dice?
Actually, yeah.
And so play this card to boost one of your rolls. What does that mean?
That would be before you roll.
Boost it by what?
By adding an extra dice.
Adding an extra dice.
Yeah.
I think I'll play this.
So you're going to play the boost for the first?
Oh, no, wait, because then I'd lose my hoof it, which might be really useful.
Yeah.
Just roll what you get first.
This is the balance you're having to play with.
Oh, yeah, because you guys
every
are going
to... has two effects on it.
You guys have said you guys can let me reroll if I get crap rolls.
Yeah.
If you roll now, you can probably pass it.
Yeah,
right,
but
so
if you don't, you've got this card.
Throwing a grenade from here to here.
Right, first guy looking for it.
Do I roll for each guy then?
Yes.
Individually. Oh, yes! Look
there
at that!
10.
One
easy.
Dead.
Squishy McSquish!
Yep, and that'll be an XP for us because it's a point of damage.
Ka-ching!
And every point of damage we do, it's important to remember to do that every time, because at the end of this, if we get an odd number of this, so say I got 5 XP, you got 4, you got 4.
Yeah.
You two would get an extra one to bring you both up to 5.
What?
Basically, at the end of this, you split the XP from the communal pool.
Yeah.
Say we had enough that I got 5, you got 4, you got 4. You would both get an extra one to bring you up to 5.
It just rounds up.
Yeah, so it rounds up evenly for everybody, okay?
Okay. Yeah. Fair enough.
It's a nice little system that keeps everybody on sort of a level playing field.
Don't feel fine. Right, next squishy guy.
Yeah, so you're going for the swords guy. Need me it?
You get 7.
7, oh, he survives.
If
this
you want,
guy
you
here.
You can do your reroll.
Oh, yeah, I can reroll.
Do you want
you
to spend
I'm
a
going to
feat
re-roll.
Card for that?
Yeah, I'm going to spend a feat, but I'm only going to re-roll one of the dice.
Okay.
Yeah! Right,
another one bites the dust.
Heebie squidgy. Last guy.
And we gain another XP.
Ka-ching!
And you don't have a feat card now. What that?
Next one. Got a 6. Re-roll that anyway.
Ah.
Hold on.
Stop. Read the card.
You've already used it in one turn.
Read the card.
Play this card to reroll any number of dice from any one of your attacks.
Any one of your attacks.
But this is all one attack. I just threw it once.
It's argumentable. We could argue it. What do you think?
I would almost say that's...
Play this card to reroll any number of dice from one of your attacks.
It is one of his attacks because it is a blast.
Yeah.
So I would agree with Lloyd on this one.
It is AoE,
it's
so it probably would hit.
Yeah, I'll agree with you, Lloyd.
Comment below if you know better than us on that.
I agree with Lloyd on this one because it is a single attack being a single grenade.
I would have thought so.
Yeah, so this guy's dead.
But he was dead anyway, was he not? Oh, he wasn't.
No, he wasn't, so you had to reroll. But that's another XP for us. So, you're an XP machine, Lloyd.
I is the man.
This dungeon's looking pretty easy now.
Which card did I use? That burnt up.
Yep.
Right, so I immediately draw a new feat.
New feat.
Yep, and we now draw a villain card. So, Remote Rumble. Activate the villain farthest away from you. So, what villain is farthest away from you, Lloyd, on the table?
Let's see. I'm here. I would say it was going to be this thug here.
So this one back here,
yeah.
He will activate.
He doesn't have
player
minus
to the
six.
Active player's William. Left. So that's who it's targeting on the bottom of this card. If I
I'm the active player, you're to my left.
So he's targeting me.
He still wouldn't have line of sight though.
Yeah, from here I'd say he wouldn't have line of sight.
Oh, he doesn't have line of sight.
Yeah.
Yeah, now he does. It's the same square. He's anywhere in that square.
Well,
he leaned a bit.
1, 2, he's not in range anyway.
Because if you're not going to let him shoot there, you probably shouldn't have let him shoot.
He wouldn't be in
here.
Range anyway here. Because, look, his range is 2. So 1, 2, 1, 2. He couldn't reach me anyway. So he has to go to his next option, all right? So his next option, which is here, says he will take a regular shot, but he gets to move 1 square first to get himself into range, okay?
Right.
So what he's going to do is he will move up to here 1 square. Now he's in range and can see me and goes 1, 2 and shoots me regularly. With a regular shot, okay?
Okay. Are we sure that I could have done what I did?
Yes.
You sure? Because
you were in range.
Because I could see this guy.
Yes, but you were in range.
Okay.
You can see him and you were in range. Okay. From here, it was going...
Shush, Lloyd, we're winning.
Whatever. Play it as I've done it. Play it as I've done it. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. Just play it as I've done it. So, Lance, you're going to roll the dice against me.
Okay.
Because you're the player to my left.
Get him!
So it's a regular shot.
If you don't survive, do you get any of the gold at the end?
Yes, you get brought back to life at the end.
What?
You get brought back to life. Nobody dies. Well, you can completely die, but it's...
But if you completely die, would we get all the gold?
No.
It's like Pokemon. They never die. They just faint.
All right, so Lance, accuracy of 4 versus my defense of 13, so you need to roll 9 or more on 2.
Okay, let's have at it. 8.
8.
Not enough.
No.
Damn you,
one down.
Whistles off into the darkness.
And then hits a wall and bounces back and hits you on the back of the head.
Let's try it.
Oh, he gets a 6! A 6 makes that happen.
I love playing with these guys. All right, so...
We just ignoring his magical 6?
Yes. Oh. So that's your turn, Don Lloyd. It's now on to you, Lance. Spawn a villain for us.
Spawn a villain.
Yeah, so black for type, white for location.
Oh, yes. So black for type.
4.
Location is 4.
4.
So we get a red crossbowman turning up over here. So that's fine.
Good.
I noticed that when you placed him down, you placed him right up tight against the wall, but maybe he should be back here so he can see your character.
Fine! Stop! Yeah.
You know, if I was a thug and I was coming in and I wanted to shoot someone with a crossbow, I probably wouldn't stand behind a wall.
You'd be a bit curious, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Probably this is a cooperative game, Lloyd.
That someone shouldn't be here. They are a target for my crossbow.
Anywho, lads, you've now spawned your guy.
Yeah.
You get to activate.
Not a big dude.
I'm going to hoof it, which means that I can move 2 spaces and I still have an action. So I'll come up to you.
Well, you can just charge and not do that.
Oh, okay.
Charge lets you melee at the end of it.
Oh, that's fine.
And
I didn't realize that.
You get to attack with both your melee weapons. You have an axe and
but you can't charge unless you do the face.
What's the face?
Put more effort into it, man.
It'd be fine.
That was the most weak ever.
So was that.
No, okay.
It wasn't my turn to go.
It's my character, Lloyd.
All right, so what's the accuracy of your weapon?
My accuracy? I'm going to use the shield first, because I think it would be more demoralizing for him.
No. Use the axe first, because your first attack, whenever you charge, is boosted, so you get 3 dice on damage.
But can I not use the shield?
You really want to. All right, fine, use the shield.
It'd be more demoralizing for the rest of the
All right,
the
charging
enemies.
In with the shield, so 2 dice to hit.
2 dice, yeah.
Your accuracy is 6, his defense is 12, so you need 6 or more.
Yeah, easy.
Oh, easy. Look at that! 10. He's in his
now,
face.
Now, 3 dice on the shield.
3 dice on the
7
shield.
Or more.
7, oh, this should be pretty easy.
Yep. So,
that's
boom,
nine.
He is dead, gone and buried, and we gain another XP from over here.
Ka-ching!
Okay, awesome.
Also, I'm going to use a feat card here, which says, play this card, it's overtake. So play this card after you incapacitate a villain with a melee attack to move 1 space.
Ah, okay.
So I can move 1 space extra.
Okay, right. Now, that's your turn done, Lance. So we're on to...
Does he need to draw a feat card?
He does need to draw a feat card. And now we're on to the villain action for Lance's turn.
I got the same feat card back again. Well...
Excellent. That'll be even more use to you.
Yeah.
Okay, so next up is the boss blitz. Activate the boss villains. There are none at the moment. If there are no boss villains in play, activate 2 villains furthest away from you. So, Lance, who are they?
I would assume...
That one and that one?
Because... No, that one's pretty close to me.
I but in a square. You count by square, not by actual distance.
Oh, okay, yeah. Those two? Yeah.
Okay, well, they're all crossbow guys at the minute, so they are all just going to shoot... And their target this time is the character with the lowest initiative.
Well, that is me.
That is unfortunate, Lance. The troll wakes up and they go, oh my god, kill it.
Me go smashy smash. Me big, big, big target.
Yeah.
Right, so Lloyd, you're going to be rolling for Lance.
Oh yeah.
Their accuracy is still 4. Lance, what's your defense?
My defense is 11.
And what stance had you chosen? Because you forgot to determine your stance.
I did. Let's go for steady.
Okay,
which means
so
I gain
1 defense?
Yep, 1 defense.
Can't be knocked down.
Can't be knocked down.
Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Yeah. You're rolling against 12. You need 8 or more, Lloyd.
Oh, the power of these dice. Can barely hold them.
Roll them.
Oh, balls. I got 6.
Yep. Okay, so the first one missed. Actually, roll 1 more, because that would have been an aim shot.
Oh,
yeah. Now you're rolling against his armor. So it's power 8. Versus Lance's armor 15. Of 15. So that means 9 or more you need.
Nope. 5, 6, 7.
All right, roll 3 for this guy, because he'll be on an aim shot as well.
6, oh, load 6, 7,
yep,
8.
So that'll
nine,
hit.
Blah, blah, blah,
so roll 2, needing 9 or more.
Nope.
Okay.
I'm good.
2 crossbow bolts sticking out of your shield now, Lance.
I'm cool
Where
with that.
Did they go, though, these crossbow bolts?
They stuck in the shield.
Oh, they didn't deflect off the shield?
No.
And hit the roof and then hit you on the top of your head?
No.
So
but if we roll like a six, can we make that happen?
No.
Oh, five! So close!
Dice God's just about saying no.
Oh.
Right, so, Lance, that's your turn done, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, so, new round means a new event's going to happen.
Woohoo!
So, this time, okay, enforcers, place two sword thugs and a crossbow thug at a random passage. So, Lance, or actually, no, it's me, so I'll roll one die and see where these guys are coming in. So, at three, so there's going to be three guys coming in over there. Blue for priority this time. So, it's two sword thugs. So, one and two of these. And one crossbow thug who will also be blue.
So two blue ones and a red ones just burst out through the passage.
Yeah. And I still have to spawn.
You just throw another grenade.
Could throw another
grenade.
Yeah. Alright, well, I have to roll to spawn. So black for type, white for location. Type 3 is a sword thug in location 2. So it's going to be a blue sword thug over here because the event is blue for this turn.
I'm getting a bit carried away over here.
Well, it's making it look more tasty for your grenades, Lloyd. Let's be honest here.
So I can be an XP machine.
Yes. Now, we're on to the activation phase for me.
Okay.
So what would I like to do?
What would you like to do?
We see, I could either keep shooting at these guys over here and try and get this clear and get our mission done.
That's you there.
Yeah. Or I could run away down this way and try and hit the side quest.
Ooh, there's side quests.
There are side quests. So the side quest can be something good or it can be something bad. It could be something good, like finding, you know, lots of gold, so that's tons of XP.
Or it could be something like...
items and stuff to help us along, or it could be monsters. It could
that
be monsters.
That would be bad.
Yeah.
I mean, high risk, high reward.
No, I'm going to be a coward. I'm not going to do it. I'm just going to stand and shoot.
Say in the comments below if you would do it.
Am I a coward?
Yes. Yes, I am.
So, I'm going to stand and shoot from here, targeting this character here.
Don't hit me.
You can shoot too, yeah?
Yeah, I can shoot two spaces. It's an aim shot, so I'm getting three dice.
Okay.
So my accuracy of 5 versus the 12.
Please don't hit me.
That'll be 7 plus 5.
It's 11.
Is that 12?
12. Yeah, it's 12.
Awesome. Just about. Just about. Obviously, brutal shot.
Yeah.
And well then.
Oh, for goodness sakes.
So one dice.
Oh, yeah, he's off.
One.
Wait, yep, there he is.
He's dead. And he goes back to here, and we gain another XP.
Ding.
Ka-ching. I am now going to use my trick shot feat, which is actually on my card. So, what it allows me to do, once per round during your turn, you can discard a feat card to make an additional ranged attack against another target in the same space as your first target.
That's good, because we've got a range in that same space.
So you're going for an immediate snapshot here?
Yeah, essentially. But I will be rolling two dice.
Okay.
So, obviously, brutal shot.
But you have to shoot through Lance.
You can shoot through your...
And maybe he's wiggling about
I'm just dodging.
And he's a big guy. He's kind of...
Your allies do not block line of sight. They're smart enough whenever you say duck to actually duck.
Fair enough.
So,
okay.
Needing 8 or more.
That's not 8 or more.
Oh, dear. I'm looking for the bullet. I think it's in your butt somewhere, Lance.
Yeah. I'm not sitting down anytime soon.
Well, I had to discard a feat card to do that.
Wait, let's just dwell on that uselessness that we just seen.
Excuse me.
I killed one.
Yeah.
You line up to something epic, boof, boof, and completely flopped.
Anyway, onto the villain action for my turn. Okay. Bolt barrage. Activate up to 2 crossbow thugs, and they target the active player. Eep.
Eep. Who's the active player? That's you.
That's me.
And we have crossbow guy here, crossbow guy there.
Yeah, and it has to be the blue ones.
Yeah.
Because blue takes priority, because it's a blue event.
Isn't that nice and handy? There's nice two here if you've got like triangular attack.
Yeah, just perfect.
So Lance, roll 2.
Okay.
You're trying to get 7 or more?
7 or more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I 6.
Miss.
That's for this one, let's say.
Yeah.
Second shot. Next one.
5.
Oh, miss.
You're pretty lucky this round.
Lance.
Yeah.
Your crappy rolls are saving my ass. Thank you.
Yeah. We'll see for later. See what happens.
So, that's my activation done. Lloyd, do you want to spawn? Wrong kind of spawn.
What do you mean spawn?
Spawn a villain.
Oh, you want me to roll some dice?
Yes.
Right. Black and a white one again?
Yeah, black for type, white for location.
Okay. 1 and a 3!
So it's going to be a swordsman at location 3.
Oh, that's getting very tasty
that
for
was
you,
a
Lloyd.
Hot shot for you right there.
Come on. Get him. In fact, do it, Ghostbusters. Get her.
Get her.
I would suggest going for it.
Think of the XP.
All that lovely, lovely XP. There's five sitting right there, Lloyd. Do you have any feats that could help? Is that what you're looking at here?
Yes.
All right. Dun, dun, dun. The wheels are turning.
So just imagine that these guys have run up the the passageway.
I'm just going to move forward one.
Okay.
Which will allow me to then chuck a...
Yeah.
A flame... No, a...
An explosive.
An explosive into here, so I've moved from there to here.
Okay.
I definitely have line of sight now, so if we got it right or wrong the first time, doesn't matter, because that is about to blow shit up.
Yep, okay.
Okay.
Right.
So chuck your grenade.
How many dice for that again? Two?
So it's two
it's one per guy, isn't it?
And it's one per guy. Their armor is 12.
Okay.
And your strength is 5.
Let's start with this red guy here.
Yep, so you're looking for 8 or more.
Yeah! Oh no, missed.
That's 7.
Crap. Yep. Blue guy here.
Yep.
Oh, missed.
5.
This thug here.
Oh. 6.
This guy here.
Yeah.
Oh.
Dead.
Oh, hey!
So that'll be an XP here.
So he got fire.
Perfect.
And one more.
Last one.
Perfect.
One.
10.
And another one. So, why are we doing
that? That's still pretty good.
We're getting quite a pile of gold here.
Well, it's all copper at the minute. 2, 4, 6. We've got 8 XP at the minute, so that's not bad.
Oh, yeah. I think I provided most of that. I think you'll find. XP machine.
I'm bragging just smelling yet. Nothing but smugness.
We have to exit the dungeon before you can brag. Yeah.
Right, so that's your activation done, Lloyd.
I have to throw
grab a feat and throw one away. Draw your new feat first. Decide which one of them you want to keep.
I will dip that and throw this away, I think.
Yep.
Oh, into a dud path.
Okay. So, villain activation, close combat. Activate the villain closest to you, and they will target the one with the lowest health.
Who's that? Is this me or you we're talking about?
Well, I'm currently on 6.
You're both 6 health.
So, roll the dice.
Well, you've lost a health, and I haven't.
Mm. What, would you say it would target you?
No, I would say it would target you.
Roll the dice. I'll be odds.
Who on the table is targeting what?
Right, so it's activate the villain closest to you, Lloyd. So who's closest to you?
I don't know.
Anyone
in here, right?
In this square, yeah.
Yeah, but you're behind me and you probably smell of blood because you've been injured.
Let's not be fancy with it. I'll take odds, you take evens.
Okay.
So, odd. So it's on me.
Yeah!
So this guy, he will activate, he will charge and go 1, 2.
Yeah.
In fact, actually, tell a lie. This one will activate, and it'll go 1, 2, because it's a blue event this turn.
Okay.
So it takes priority, and he will attack me. So Lance, do you want to roll 2 dice?
Come on, stabby McStab.
Let's see what happens.
Yep,
he's got 2 9. Swords, so 2 dice for it.
Ooh,
that's an 8.
Eight.
Ooh,
8 plus is 4 is 12. My defense is 13.
Oh,
so close.
Yeah. Crappy rolls from Lance. Excellent. I like playing this game. All right, so that was your turn done, Yellow?
Yeah, that'd be me.
You've got your feet. So
done
it's my
feet.
Turn.
Done his feet. Yep.
I roll for spawn.
Yep.
So 1 black.
Black for type, white for location.
Black for type. Type 1.
So it's going to be a sword guy.
Location is
6.
6.
So we're getting a sword guy coming in way over here.
Uh-huh.
You know, I was thinking we were mowing through the minions quite quickly here, but they do just sort of gather up again, which is quite annoying.
I'm going to go for stance, which will be mighty.
Okay,
and
again,
additional dice on melee damage rolls.
Okay, so I assume you're moving in?
Yeah, I'm going to move in. I'm going to attack this ranger.
Wait, before you do that though. Mm-hmm. Like, do you want additional damage rolls for one guy? Because you've just moved from here to here.
Well, could I not move? If I attack him...
That space is then clear.
I can move here with this feed card.
Oh, right, okay, carry on.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then that's our objective square cleared as well, which will be useful. So go ahead, Lance, attack.
So attack, my attack is...
So you're needing 6 on 2.
6. I'm going to use the axe this time.
Okay. So you hit.
Easy.
His armor is 12, so you need 4 on 2.
And I gain an extra dice because of Mighty.
Here's the thing. You charged,
and
Mighty grants you an additional, does it say, or boosted?
It is, you gain an additional dice.
So roll 4.
Can I have another dice, please?
This is what I'm talking about. This seems like overkill.
This guy should be going down.
I think he might be
pasted.
Dead.
Absolutely pasted.
He is smeared across the wall. I've made an elegant painting. And because of that, I'm going to use counter charge.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's not. It is overtake.
Okay.
Which one did you use before?
It was overtake, but I got it again.
Yeah.
No, man. You used the feet off your card.
Yeah.
Your special ability, right? Yeah. Okay, so
the feat I'm going to use is overtake. Play this card after you incapacitate a villain with a melee attack to move one space.
You didn't incapacitate him, you squished him.
Yeah. So, like, now you got to move. For that. But you don't get to continue attacking, I don't believe.
No? Okay.
Because you've... Actually, would you? I'm not sure.
If he'd stayed there, would he have got to search for the Death Star plans?
No, because he would have used his action to attack.
Blind fury.
But when you attack with both melee weapons if able. You're now in another square and still have a melee weapon to attack with. I'm going to say you can attack with the shield.
I have another feat here called backswing. Play this card... Oh.
Well, attack with your shield first.
Are you sure he can do this?
You attack with both your melee weapons. So he's still in melee now. So I would say yes.
Okay.
So attack with your shield. 6 or more on 2 dice.
Shield. I pulled this feat card too soon.
No, you pull it. Yeah.
2 dice.
2 dice, needing 6.
6.
Yep.
Yay!
10. Needing 7 next time.
7, and again additional because of my stance.
Yep.
Ah, there's a 2 easy.
Tasted.
Squish man.
Squished.
Now, do these guys get, like, fear checks or anything against me?
No. No, they don't.
Because that would be pretty perfect.
There are abilities you can get that, I think, cause terror in some games, but I'm not sure if it's in this one. We'll have to have a look.
Yes, because we have ability cards and stuff, but I figure we don't get these until next turn.
We wouldn't get them, until next mission. So at the end of this mission, we divide that XP up evenly between us.
Because it's a progress system on this game.
Yes, exactly. And then it shows us leveling up and getting better. Okay?
I've drawn a feat card, now villain action.
Yeah, villain action happens. So
activate the villain closest to you.
So, close combat, activate the villain closest to you, and it's going to target the character with the highest health.
That's me.
Yeah, it's going to target you, Lance. Unfortunately, it's going to target you.
That's okay.
Now, the other thing is...
you saw what happened to the previous villains.
Yeah. Now, the other thing is... It's the villain closest to you, Lance. So I'm guessing it'll be one of these. And because our event is blue, it's going to be the sword guy. So he is going to charge into you and attack you. You get to roll for Lance now. So, Lance, what's your defense? 11, yeah?
My defense is 11.
Right, so 11 minus 4.
2 dice.
Yep.
Prepare to be stabby.
So 7 or more on 2 dice.
Power.
Roll, goddamn.
The power.
Come on, you've got fear in you.
Oh, he hits. Right. Nice. Now, power 8 to armor 15 means you need to roll 9 or more.
On 2 dice?
Yes.
Come the damage.
Eight.
Oh, so close!
Nada. That's fine.
I think I'm enjoying this too much.
And I can't counterattack that now.
No, because it would have to damage you to do a counterattack, yeah?
Just how greedy are you? You've killed 2 guys.
I have a feat here because it says vengeance. Play this card to make a melee attack against a villain that hit you with a melee attack after that.
He hit you.
Yeah.
He did
didn't have to damage you. Can't do it.
Goodness, man.
So you can spend that feat if you want.
Yeah.
Now, don't forget, you did play your overtake. So, yeah. And then you drew one. So, yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
You probably shouldn't have drawn that until the end of the turn.
No, it's drawn at the end of your activation. Before the villain turn starts, you draw your feat.
But then it's not his turn, so how's he playing a feat?
Because the feat says when to activate it.
Oh.
So it's saying after a villain has hit you.
Yeah, so it's a reactive attack.
Exactly. So even if it was during your activation, the villain activated it and hit Lance, he could use it.
I done got it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so hitting with the axe, I assume. So you're needing 6 or more on 2.
6.
That'll hit.
That's 7. And another dice as well because of my stance. Mighty.
Because of Mighty.
What did I have to beat?
Armor 12.
Armor 12.
Squished.
I did get it.
He's a dead man.
We done got gold.
We done got more gold.
Ka-ching!
That's a lot of gold we're gathering.
Yeah, this dungeon's getting pretty easy.
Okay, so...
Well, it is the first mission in the book.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you say that. We still possibly have a boss fight at the end of this.
That's fine.
All right. So, that's your turn done, yeah, Lance?
Yep.
Okay, so now it's my activation. So, new round, new event.
Yeah, we've already done the event, because all that happened there.
No. That was the villain activation.
Okay.
Because it's a new round, we get
a brand new
event card, which is one of these, okay?
Yes.
So the new event is Lucky Thugs. All thugs gain an additional die on attack rolls. Drop the lowest die from each roll. So these guys are going to start hurting this turn. And it's a red priority turn. So black for type, white for location. So it's a type 4 in location 5. So that's going to be a red crossbowman coming out here. Wonderful. Lance, there are new friends for you to play with.
Fantastic.
All right, so it's now my activation, and I have a choice to make.
Yes.
So currently in melee over here, but I can walk away from it if I want. So what I think I'm going to do is, yes, I'm going to try and walk away from it.
Excuse me.
No.
Excuse me.
Yes.
I'm in the square. You're just going to leave me stand on my own?
Yes.
But I'm like a...
Are you not hit by your cloak?
I'm like a magey guy. I dodge stuff. I don't deal with stuff.
You're still as dodgy in close combat as you are in range.
You can be like Frodo in Lord of the Rings where they hide under the cape.
Yeah.
Because I've done this forever, I have to make a hazard roll to see if the actual guy gets a free strike at me. Basically...
He never lets us have any fun.
On a 5 or a 6, I'll take damage, right?
Okay.
You gotta be kidding me.
Yeah, look at that! So, that's what you get. That's what you get for leaving me standing there.
I will take damage.
Wiggling about, trying to avoid getting stabbed.
I will take damage, but I do still get to leave. So, I'll continue my movement up to here for next round. Standing on the dead guy. And now it's on to the villain activation.
There are laws against
this. What does it smell like?
Like a dead body. Mm. Okay, so, villain activation this time is Boss Blitz.
This is essentially grave robbery.
Activate the boss villains. There are none yet. If no boss villains are in play, activate the two villains closest to you. They attack the ones with highest initiative.
That would be these two.
No.
Yes.
I could activate one of these.
Right.
Actually, yeah, because it's a red turn, so yes, these two would activate.
Well, you could activate one of these, which would be kind of cool, because if it got over...
No, but he's too far away.
But it could go stabby, McStabby.
No. Going to activate this one.
Okay.
These two will activate and go after me.
And they're probably going to shoot you.
Yes, they are. With aim shots. So Lance, three dice.
Lance, get your big butt out of the way.
Three dice plus
Let's
four.
Let's just move you out of the way and make sure these shots get through. There we go.
All right. The three dice for aim shots. that'll be eight.
That's neat.
Plus four is 12. Is not enough.
Oh!
I know it.
Oh!
There you go. You're safe, Justin.
Mike, Lance.
Yeah?
You are an expert crap dice roller right now. I'm loving it.
Hey, I'm pretty good at good dice rolls too.
If anybody needs an automated DM system, here is your man.
Yeah. But I do like the system for this game. I love the fact that it runs on itself and it's your friends that are rolling against you and going, oh, I'm sorry, mate, or I got you, mate.
But it's only him. I never get the chance.
Yeah, because he never gets targeted because you roll for him and I roll for you. Anyway. On to your activation, Lloyd, because you're the next initiative.
Do I even have time to activate? I'm sitting wiggling around trying not to get stabbed.
But first, spawn a monster.
Oh.
Black for type, white for location.
Here we go. Six.
So it's going to be a crossbowman coming in over here. And because there were more blue crossbowmen than red, it's a blue crossbowman that comes in.
Yeah, but he wouldn't be standing back there. He'd be like right up front. There you go, look at that. Make sure you can see what's going on.
Okay, fine.
He wants to see what
it's
is going on.
It's a proper assault towards me right now.
He'd be like, they're a big ass troll. I want to see what's going on.
All right, so now you get to activate Lloyd. So you could try and leave that square and risk taking the free strike. Or you do have a knife, so you could try and shank him.
Or I could have some magical type abilities or something.
If you've read a magical type ability, yeah.
Yep. Play this card when moving out of a space with an enemy to ignore its free strikes.
Okay.
And I'm going to play Hoof It as well.
Okay.
And I is going to run 1, 2.
Oh, Christ. Are you going for the...
Oh, wait. I don't have to play Hoof It for that. I could just charge.
Yeah, you could.
Yeah, I'm not going to play Hoof
It. Well, actually, if you play Hoof It, it means you can throw a grenade back at him.
Oh, yes. We're doing that.
Insult to injury.
You're right getting there. It. You's in trouble now.
So I assume Poison Vial?
Oh, yeah.
Or Acid Vial?
Here we go.
Okay, so... what's your ACC?
Five.
Five.
Accuracy's 5 to 12, so you need 7 or more.
Let's do this. Yeah! I got an 8!
Right, armor power 9 you are, yeah?
Yeah.
To armor 12, so it's 5 or more? No, 4 or more.
Oh, so yeah!
He's dead. And we gain more.
Give us the gold!
Ching! Yeah. Okay, so he's dead. That's right. Fine.
I need to draw a feat card here. So they go in my discard
just
pile.
Yeah, I need to draw
one.
Did I draw a feat card at the end of my last?
Don't remember.
Yeah, whatever. Be alright.
Do I get any more? Do I kind of do anything else?
Nope, that's you done. We're now on to the villain activation.
Villain action.
So, villain action this turn. Crimson Carnage. Activate up to two red villains closest to you. If there are no red villains, activate one of the villains closest to you. Target is the highest initiative. Thanks, Lloyd.
As in closest to you? We're talking about you?
No, closest to you.
Oh, but I'm way over here.
Yeah, so these guys will activate. So these two red villains are going to activate and shoot me again.
Well, that's what you get.
Stop trying to murder me, Lloyd.
We charged in and tried to take all the glory.
Yeah.
You're in there squidging that body down.
Yeah, where is this document? I want to get paid today.
Hands in all the little gaps. Where might this document be? If I was a secret agent, I think that's what I'd do.
You've been through. Right, what do I need?
Right, so they're shooting me with their 4. I'm 13.
Give it
to
them.
You're looking for 9 or more.
Oh, you get 6, 7.
7 misses for the first one and the second.
Oh, there you go.
So that'll hit. 10. So it's power 8 to my armor of 12, so you're looking for 5 or more.
Uh-huh, on 2 dice?
On 2 dice.
5 or more.
Actually, that first one would have actually had 3 dice to hit. You've done 5 here, so I am taking a point of damage, but re-roll that first one with 3 dice.
First one with 3 dice.
Because it's an aim shot, because they're not moving.
So that's
a hit.
That's 10 again.
Yep, so 2 dice, needing 5 or more.
5 or more.
The 3. Thing. Okay, yes. That's fine. Just to try and keep it right. Because whenever they don't move, they get the aim shot.
Okay, it was just the 2 guys shooting you.
It was just the 2 guys.
This blue one doesn't want to wee crack at you as well.
No, because it's a red turn, and it said Crimson Carnage, so the 2 reds activate.
Okay.
Okay, so you're done, Lloyd. Lance, spawn a villain.
Spawn a villain, okay. Black for type.
Yep, so
and
4.
For location.
So it's going to be a red one.
Over here.
Because they have priority. And he's going to spawn over here. Okay. Lloyd, why are you running away from us?
I'm going for the secret quest.
Now he's going for glory. You're going for the treasure, yeah?
Well, yeah, it might be treasure.
Might be treasure. All right, so Lance, you now get to activate as normal.
Yeah.
So would you like to charge in here?
Yes, of course.
So you're going to get beat in.
Yep.
So he charges in, beats him back.
I am known as the Picasso of this dungeon.
Right, so which of your abilities are you taking?
I'm taking Mighty, which gives me an extra dice on damage rolls.
Yep. Okay.
Let's hope you have some major abilities, because you've got 3 guys to beat off at the same time.
All right, I would suggest attack red guys first, because they have priority this turn. So this guy,
I assume
with your axe?
Yes.
Okay.
I hit.
Oh, that my goodness!
Yep. Yeah. And then 3 dice, actually 4 dice for damage with Mighty.
4 damage.
He's dead.
He is dead.
I think I've lost the crown as the XP machine here.
Smeared across the other 2 guys.
Yep, next guy with the shield, needing a 6. That'll hit.
Oh my goodness.
3 dice.
3 dice.
He's dead.
He is dead as well. I have a feat here.
Did you give us gold the last time, yeah?
I did.
Which is called Backswing. Play this card during your turn to make an attack with one of your weapons.
Yeah, so that you can attack the last blue guy with your axe.
Yeah.
You did have enough to beat off 3 guys.
All right.
So you is the man.
Guy, you're needing 6 again.
I am known for
it. Oh, just about. Okay, 3 with the axe.
Yep, yeah, 3 with the axe.
Needing a 4 or more.
4 or more.
Yep, he's
dead.
Yeah,
easy.
Wow.
Squid 8.
You are enraged.
Ka-ching!
Yeah, that's
very
that's
impressive.
Feet now?
Draw a feet now.
Draw 1 feet.
And I'll draw a villain action. So, pressure point. Activate the villain closest to you. Reshuffle the villain action deck after discarding this card. So, discard that and I'll have to reshuffle this.
Oh. What's going on?
What was the point of that, though?
Because it reshuffles the order that this is.
Actually, but we didn't know what order that was.
Actually, wait, no. It's this. I have to reshuffle.
Yeah, into that.
At least I think that's it. Reshuffle the villain deck, action deck. Oh, so I assume I'm reshuffling this in. I'm not sure if I'm doing it right or not, but I'm doing it.
What difference would it make? anyway.
Well, it made
it
no
basically
difference.
Means that there are some actions that could then re-happen.
It made no difference when he lifted it and shuffled the actions that hadn't happened, because what difference did it make? It hadn't happened.
Yeah, reshuffling this into it means all those actions that could have happened can happen again now, and possibly sooner than we would like. But the villain closest to you is one of these, Lance. So it's a red turn, so pick a red thug. Which one would you like to activate?
Oh, I'm going to activate the swordsman.
Okay.
Why does he get to pick?
Because it's the same color and it says active turn.
But why does he get to pick between the two?
Okay, so the red are the priority for this turn. It simply said activate the villain closest to you. So
it probably is this guy.
So one of these.
Yeah.
And this guy, he will then go 1-2. No, don't roll for it. You get to pick. So he goes 1-2 and he's now staring at me. Okay? So that's Lance's turn done.
Mm-hmm.
We now are on to a new round, so it's a new event. Okay, so Fogbank. All characters gain +1 defense against ranged attacks. That could be good.
Does that mean, is that just us or does that everybody on the table?
Well, it says characters.
Where are the characters? Because they're just the minions.
Yeah, they're thugs.
Okay.
So
there's actually some events are good for you by the looks of it.
Yeah. Okay, so black for type, white for location. So it's a type 5 in location 1. So that's going to be a blue crossbowman way down over here. We're getting a little bit of a gun line down here. So I will activate, and for my action, I'm going to search for the documents. So
here we go.
This token comes away. I found the documents.
Where was it? Where did you find it?
In his coat
pocket. I thought he was going to say something weird there.
Cut to the table. Cut to the table. So what happens now is this now comes off. We find the documents.
Okay.
And now we have to roll.
Yeah.
On a 1-2-3, this guy will turn up here. On a 4-5-6, this guy will turn up. Okay?
Let's roll a 6, Justin.
3.
Oh, for goodness sake.
So the big guy's turning up. To find out where he's turning up, he's turning up at location 3. So he's turning up over here. Now, to finish this mission, we have to kill him. Okay?
Could you have spawned him any further away from us?
You ran away!
I'm on a side quest.
Side quest my ass.
Lloyd's quest.
Lloyd's Quest. Okay, that's what we're calling this show. Lloyd's Quest.
I'm giving up on that. I can't do the voice.
You've seen a pile of something sitting over there with something shiny in it. Is it really a good idea to go poking around down in a dungeon?
That's the whole point of going in a dungeon. Is
that not what you just did there in that body?
Yeah. No!
You just went, found the plans. Nobody look. Got the plans.
Ew.
Where's our starship? We need to get these to the princess straight away.
Steampunk world, goddamn you. Okay, now, the epic Ogryn Brute is quite nasty. So, he has vitality of 4, which means we have to do 4 points of damage to actually kill him. Strength of 6, defense of 11, so he's easy enough to hit, armor 14, which hurts, and he's got 2 hammers. So he'll get to attack twice with accuracy 6 and power 11. So he's really going to hurt whenever he gets into melee, okay?
Yes.
So we really, really need to get to work taking him down as quickly as possible.
And we have to kill him.
We have to kill
him. What happens if we don't kill him?
We lose.
Wait, what do you mean we lose?
If all of us go unconscious,
yes.
Or if this event deck runs out, we lose.
Can we load how many events we've got left?
I'm going to cheat and say 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 more rounds.
Oh, goodness.
So we each get 4 more turns to kill him.
Oh, we each get 4 more turns to kill him, right.
Yeah,
okay.
That should be easy.
If you guys get on with it, because I'm on my side quest.
Right. I'm on my side quest.
You're just relying on us to...
I'm gonna clean up those dungeons.
Anyway.
I hope that side quest is terrible so you get nothing.
I hope he gets a monster. Because you can't get monsters on the side quests.
Hey, you didn't say that. Did he say that earlier? I thought he said you get gold and gear. Yeah.
Gold and gear and monsters.
Oh.
Alright, anyway. The villain activation is going to be crossing swords. Activate up to 2 sword thugs closest to you. If there are no sword thugs in play, activate the villain farthest from you. Target active player. So, I have to activate 2 sword thugs closest to me.
There's only one sword thug.
Here's a key. It says up to 2. Because there is 1 close to me, I can activate him, and I can have him move in and attack me. But I only have to do that 1. So that's good. That actually works out quite well. Mm. Oh, also, forgot. Need to take a feat. Okay, I can work with that. So, Lance, roll 2 dice.
Okay, for his damage, or for his attack?
For his attack, yep.
3, he misses.
Misses. Awesome!
Useless automated DM roller.
All right, so that'll be my turn. Lance, it's on to you.
What? Is that all you did?
Yeah, I searched the body.
Right.
And I got the boss to come along.
You don't get to shoot nothing?
No, because my action was searching the body.
No special feats you're going to use?
No.
We've got this big-ass guy here to kill.
Next turn.
And you're just sort of standing around going, I found the plans.
Yeah.
Lloyd,
it's your activation now, so spot for us.
This side quest over here, right?
Yeah.
How far do I need to get? Do I actually
have to get into there? But you could do a run and get into there, or do a hoof it and get into there.
Right, well, let's spawn up first.
Right, black for type. So three, it's going to be a sword guy in one. So it's going to be a blue sword guy up here.
Oh, well, that's handy.
No, does that max?
No. Because they can hold seven.
He counts as two,
I think. As two, so there's currently six in there, okay?
Mm-hmm.
That's the way that works.
Okay. Now, will I side quest it or not?
Well, you're already there.
Yeah. Let's do it.
This looks like a bad plan.
Let's do it! I'm just going to run over here.
High risk, high reward.
Will I be able to search if I run?
As soon as you get on that tile, it flips.
Let's do it! Yeah!
So, one, two.
Let's see what we get.
This is going to be terrible.
Drudge pack.
That sounds good.
Two men that have been surgically altered into terrifying creatures burst into the tunnels nearby, attacking anything they can reach in murderous frenzy.
Whose stupid idea was this?
Yours?
Where do they burst out of?
Right here.
No, it said nearby. It didn't say right beside me.
That was the fluff.
It didn't say right beside me. It implied that maybe they could be anywhere, like over...
Roll a die. Place a red drudge and a blue drudge at the matching passage. Okay, so they come in from one of these.
Oh, do you see that? He tried to screw me over there. Right.
Drudges are significant villains that activate at initiative one. They also activate on action cards normally. So they'll always act at the end of the round now.
Okay.
So you're hoping for a 4 or 6.
Red guy.
4, 5, or 6.
5.
Yeah, both of them at 5 then.
I thought you had a roll for each one.
No.
Yeah.
Roll a die, place a red drudge and a blue drudge at the matching passage. So it's roll once.
That's all right. You can deal with them.
Okay, so...
You're big and bulky.
There's a bounty on this. So, when a drudge is incapacitated, add 1 XP to the treasury in addition to the XP gained from damaging the villain. Now,
slow down.
They're worth double XP.
We're getting carried away here.
Yeah.
What did I find?
Those.
But what gold did I find?
None.
Essentially nothing happened.
What equipment did I find?
Basically, as you walked around the corner, you triggered a story event.
What? There's bound to have been something lying on the floor.
No.
You're not even going to give me like a dagger?
No. You already have a dagger. Don't be greedy.
An egg timer.
Right. Anyway, cut to here. So, the thing is, these guys have vitality 1, which means you can't just crush them on the one go.
Oh, there you go.
Unfortunately, they have resilient flesh, which means you have to do 2 points of damage in a go to actually kill them.
You can do this, Lance. You can do it. Use the beefcake.
If this character takes normal damage, it is knocked down. So do 1 point of damage and you can knock them down. And on the second point of damage, while they are knocked down, you can kill them. Okay?
Yes.
Now, thankfully, it's not the epic drudge because they're even worse. Because all monsters in this have a regular face and an epic face, which is a lot more scary when it goes to the epic face. Thankfully, it's a regular drudge.
Epic face.
So, for every point of damage you do in this game, you gain an XP.
Yeah.
Because of these, whenever you heal them, you gain double XP. Okay?
Okay.
Nice.
All right. So, Lloyd, you finished your activation, yes?
Let me see if there's anything I should be doing here.
Drawing a feat.
Can I be running around, bouncing on walls?
What, no.
Anything? No, I'm done.
You draw your feet?
Oh, I draw my feet.
You draw your feet up? Yep.
Yep.
So I will draw this, and it's the Azure Assault. Activate up to 2 blue villains closest to you. If there are no blue villains in play, activate 1 of the villains closest to you. Target highest initiative.
There's plenty of blue villains.
Closest to you, Lance.
Oh, well then that's one there.
It's one of the drudges, yes. Now, because he's already in melee, he will go to his first action.
Why is he already in melee?
Because he's in the same square as Lance.
Okay.
So he will just take a swing at Lance because he's in melee square with him.
Rude.
If he hadn't been in the same square, he would have targeted me and tried to move towards me. Okay? Or if he had been nowhere near, he would have just tried to move towards me.
Uh-huh.
So he's getting an attack at Lance. Lloyd, you're going to roll this.
Oh, yeah.
So accuracy of 5, so it's 6 or more.
Oh, look at that. 4.
You miss.
I turned into Lance for a dice roll there.
Yeah. Okay, so
I can't attack back?
No, not at this point. However, the next closest one, Lance, if you want to pick one of these, will activate.
This one here.
You could. You actually could if you want to be. It's Lance's choice. Do you want to do that, Lance?
If you were the automated DM, would you send one of the little minions in, or would you just send the big one in?
No. Yeah. I agree with that. Yeah.
Okay.
Where does it go to, though?
Basically, for his activation, he gets to move two squares. Yeah, and he can't move this way because there's a blocked edge here. Okay.
Okay.
So he's moving to there. He says, "I hear something around the corner. I might go and smash it."
Yeah.
Okay, so that's the end of that for you, Lloyd. Lance, it's your turn. Spawn.
My turn. Spawn.
Yeah,
okay.
Black for type.
I think I might have thrown
black
a bit
type
of a,
two.
A,
so bit of a sword spawn.
And area three.
I think I might have thrown a bit of a cat in the bag.
Yeah.
Cat among the pigeons?
Cat among the pigeons. Oh, God.
Is that funny?
No.
Apparently it was.
I'm going to attack this guy. I'm going to take let's go for mighty. Yeah.
All right, so which one are you attacking first? Mighty is a blue priority round, so I would suggest the blue guy.
Yeah, let's go for blue.
Okay, so his defense is 11.
Yeah, I can do it.
Versus your... So it's 5 or more on 2.
You're not getting any pluses or anything?
That's fine.
6.
Okay, and so, now it's your mighty. So it's 3 dice, because you didn't charge.
Damage.
His armor is 14.
I'm going to reroll this with my feat card. Play this card to reroll any number of dice from one of your attacks or stat challenges.
Okay.
So reroll this one.
Wait, that's 9 plus 9 is 18, right? His armor is 14.
Yeah.
Here's the way this works. If you do up to 4 damage, it's 1 point of health. If you do 5 or more, it's 2. So that is 2 points of damage, and he dies.
And how much experience? Double experience?
Double experience.
So we get 2 little ka-chings.
Yeah, we get double ka-ching.
Did I even need to use this?
Yeah?
What? I didn't even need to use son.
But you rolled anyway, so you've used it.
No, but he didn't need to use it.
He didn't need to use it.
I did use it, so let's play by the
Seeing as Lance sent the big guy toward me, I'm going to force him to have used that. So you've still got your shield to attack the other one.
Yes, let's attack the other one.
5 or more on 2.
5 or more on 2. Oh, okay. 10.
Okay, so again, he's on his armor of 15.
15.
Oh, actually, he's just knocked down then, because you would have done 1 point of damage.
Uh-oh.
So you could target him again to finish him off. You did 18 points of damage, yeah?
Yeah, this guy's back.
So he's on the ground, you can attack him. Let's say you've hit him because you already rolled the hit.
What happens if he stays on the ground? Will he get up next turn?
He will get up again.
Okay. Squish him.
So squish him.
Yeah, let's squish him.
Okay.
So... Three dice, how much do I need?
Armor of 15 to your power of 6.
Oh, you needed more than that. You know that reroll thing that you didn't need to use?
Yeah.
Yeah, would have been handy, wouldn't it?
Well, he's knocked down, that's still good.
He has to forfeit his action or his movement to get back up again. So he'd probably forfeit his movement and stand up and smack you.
Okay, let's move on. What happens now? Did you draw your feet card?
Can I move out?
No.
Did you draw your feet card?
No, not yet.
All right, villain activation for you, Lance. As your assault, activate up to 4 blue villains. If there are no blue villains in play, activate the 2 villains closest to the player, lowest initiative they target.
So that's going to be me.
Yes. So, Lance, what's going to happen here is he's going to stand up and attack.
Uh-huh.
He's going to go 1, 2.
I don't like this.
They're going to go...
This is perfect.
1,
yeah,
2.
For you.
Because we need to kill this guy. And now he's right up beside our most meatiest, badass, kick-ass dude.
Yeah.
Which be you, Lance.
It is. Yeah.
So, the guy who stood up and attacked you, Lloyd, you'll have to roll this. So it's accuracy 5 versus Lance's 11. So it's 6 or more on 2.
Below.
Oh. Nope, it hits. His strength is 12 versus Lance's armor.
Yeah!
So that's
4.
16. So that's 1 above his armor. Take a point of damage, Lance.
Oh, I celebrated a little early there.
That's fine.
Okay. This guy doesn't get to attack because he doesn't have any ranged attacks.
Okay.
If it had been the little Rulik Merc, he would have got to attack. Other than that, these guys have moved up. They don't get to attack.
Mm-hmm.
So, new round. Okay?
Yes.
So, new event. Ominous Silence.
Thank goodness for that.
Nothing happens.
So we're getting a little bit of a break here.
How we look around.
Right, so I have to spawn a village.
Yeah, you can.
See if there's anything else to go and poke at.
It's type 4 in location 4. So it's going to be a ranged guy. It's going to be a red one here in location 4 with you, Lance.
Well, so that's just
something else
dandy.
That you could.
Why don't any of you guys have, like, grenades?
Now, this is actually good for you, Lance, if we get one more villain in there. Because as it stands, in here we currently have 2, 3, 4, 5. So if you can get another one guy in here, he can't fit, so he can't move into you.
Yeah, but that means there's another guy in my space.
Yes, but it means the big guy's not in at you.
I don't see why this is a good
thing.
We're
running out of turns, and we want Lance to whack the big guy.
Yeah. So actually, Lance, whenever your turn comes around, you don't have to fight these.
Mm-hmm.
You could just walk away, but you would have to do a hazard roll for each of them. So three rolls needing less than a 5 or a 6.
Would all three guys have a whack at him if you tried to walk away?
All three would take a whack at him.
Unless I got a feat card, but
yeah.
I don't.
Yeah. All right, anyway, so it's my activation.
Okay.
Hold on a second. When a villain enters your space connected to your space, play this card immediately to move into your space and make an attack against them. Could I just walk into...
You could, yeah.
When a villain does what? Enters a space connected to your space, yeah.
Yeah, but I would say you will have to take the hazard check from these guys because you're moving out of their space.
I may as well do it now.
All right, so let's say you've done that. He's moved out to here.
Mm-hmm.
So do a roll of 3 dice. Any 5s or 6s, you'll take a point of damage. 2 points of damage.
That's
wunderbar. Okay? But you do get to attack the big guy.
Mm-hmm.
With your axe, I assume. And your almighty stance. So his defense is 11 versus your 6, so it's 5 or more on 2. So that
easy.
Hits.
Yeah.
Mighty with your 3 dice.
3 dice.
His armor is 14 versus your 9, so it's 6 or more.
Okay.
That'll do.
Easy.
So that'll do 1 point of damage to him. So, point of damage.
And he's got 4 right points of...
Yeah, he's got 4 points of vitality.
Yeah.
But so that's at least
3
one.
Damage, yeah.
Good. All right.
So, fast forward to my turn again. So spawn's done, I've just activated it.
Yeah.
So I am going to move out of here, taking the hazard roll.
Okay.
So, hopefully not a 5 or a 6. 4, I'm fine. So I've just about dodged out of the way. I'm now going to fire...
What about these other blue ones? They didn't get to stab at you on your way past?
No, because they weren't in the same square as me.
But you had
I moved diagonally.
Oh, okay. Right, yep, that's
okay.
Fine.
So... I'm going to fire a black penny. You can make ranged attacks against targets in the same space as a friendly figure.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you're attacking the big guy?
Yeah, I'm going to attack the big guy with that. I'm also going to use this, which is called Lucky Bullet, which means play this card, use one additional rune shot effect on your next target this turn.
Sweet.
So I can do the black penny to shoot into melee, and I can get an extra dice on my damage roll.
Nice.
Yeah. So, 7 plus 5 is what?
12.
It's 12. His defense is 11, so I've hit. Doing brutal damage of power 8, so I need 7 or more. Oh, yes.
Have you done something epic, Justin?
That'll be 12 plus 5 is 17.
That's
minus 4.
Minus 4 is 13.
Not enough. It does take another point of damage, though. I was hoping to do the 5 points of damage and double up, but I almost forgot. For each of those points of damage, we do gain an XP. So 1, 2.
Beautiful.
Ching, ching.
So we've got lots of XP for this game.
Mm-hmm.
Right. My activation's done. On to the villain phase.
Remember to draw a feat card?
Feat card.
Yeah. So I'll draw my feat card as well. Hoof it and brace shot, which is good. But close combat, activate the villain closest to me. So I can pick which villain it is.
I wonder who that is.
With the highest health. So, Lance, do you think you could take a shot from him?
Yeah.
Okay, so
could.
we'll activate the boss. And he will attack you. So, Lloyd, do you want to roll it?
Be crap.
Accuracy of 6, so 5 or more on 2.
Oh no.
Oh no! Power of 11, so 5 or more on 2.
Oh no, be crap.
That'll do it. So another point of damage on you, Lance. You do have a feat, Lance, that
you could
start to start your card during your turn to actually heal up.
You've still got 4.
Yeah, I'll be fine.
All right.
Okay. I still have all my health, by the way.
So, that's
just that good.
Done. Yeah, you sneaky little runner. Right, Lloyd, it's going to be your activation, so spawn.
I'm coming to save you all.
Spawn first.
I'm going to do that now.
Black and white. Black type, white location.
Black got one,
so
the other one's a six.
Swordsman coming in here. Dun, dun, dun.
Right.
Now you can't move diagonally, can you?
Because he's ready, wall. He's ready to, for me to come and save you?
Yeah.
Yeah. You have
it's about
it.
Time you done something, Lloyd.
No, I don't have a hoof it.
Just run. Oh, that's dear. All you can do.
Right. He's running.
Yeah. So.
One.
Nope. Oh. Because this is blocked off, she can't move diagonally.
Well, then
so
you move me.
One, one. Two.
Well, okay. that was pretty anticlimactic.
Yeah.
Is that the
yeah.
word?
You're not a parkour master in this.
No. But can I not throw a flask?
You're just bumbling around dark
like,
corners.
If I throw my flask like that, can, no. I, can, I, not do, can I not do not the wanted, wanted
no,
throw?
No, you cannot oh. do a wanted
throw. You're not James McAvoy.
But if I six it?
Mythbusters disproved right. that theory.
But this is fantasy.
All right, so we have a villain activation, Lloyd, from you. Okay, so,
you're
Crimson
welcome.
Carnage, activate up to two red villains closest to you. If there are no red villains in play, activate one of the villains closest to you. Target with the highest initiative.
It says to you, is that to me?
Target is the
closest
highest
to
initiative.
You, yes, Lloyd. Closest to you.
Right, red villains closest to me.
So that would be these guys or this guy. So
well, this target. Guy can possibly have an idea that I'm coming around the corner. Like, because I'm standing over there, let's say.
All right, so he's you're activating attacking. Him.
Justin?
Yes.
He'll target me. He will charge in and attack me.
Oh.
So my defense is 13 versus your 4, so 9 or more. 6, you miss.
Mm-hmm. My goodness, you are consistently crap at rolling dice.
Consistently
or consistently good, depending on how you look at it.
Well, he's yeah. actually consistently crap when he's rolling against me, and consistently good when he's rolling against the enemies. Yep. I'm sensing shenanigans.
Hey, I'm not doing anything.
Are you one of these weird people that can masterfully roll a dice to any oh, face you want?
I have I to throw know, one of my maybe. Feet away.
Yeah, you do, and draw a new one.
Simple stimulant.
Well, do you have to throw it away?
I never
yes,
use that.
Because you have to draw a new one. Yeah, but you could throw away the one that you
if
just it, draw.
If it, yeah.
Oh, no, that's much better.
Now he's happy enough.
Oh, I've got a new hoof it.
All right, so Lance, spawn.
Spawn.
Yep. So three, type 3 in location 6. Mm-hmm. So that's going to be one of these. It's going to be a blue because they have priority. Oh my god, there's a lot of stuff here.
That is a perfect place
for a grenade,
bomb.
Yeah.
I'm on my way, I can't get yeah. there any quicker.
Alright, Lance, now you get to attack. I assume you're taking Mighty.
I'd be there
do
if you guys...
Do you have a feat that can do anything extra as well?
I'd be there if you guys hadn't told me to go and do the side quest.
We didn't tell you shit!
Might have. That's what I think you did.
No, I don't have a feat.
Comments got... below! Call him out on his BS!
I've got backswing and bodyguard, which don't really help me.
Actually, backswing could help would you help. Because it means you could possibly do 3 damage and end this before Lloyd yeah. gets
do
a chance
it.
To throw his
grenade.
So, let's go for Mighty.
Okay. So, defensive 11.
Mm-hmm.
So it's 2 dice needing 4s, I believe. Your attack is 6.
My attack is 6, yes.
So it's 2 dice needing 5s, sorry. Hits.
5.
So... Your Mighty gives you 3 dice.
And damage is...
that'll do it.
10, 12.
That'll
plus
do it.
9.
12
21.
Plus 9, 21. Is that... Yeah, that's enough. That actually does. If I bring this in. So, you see the way his armor's 14 here. Because he already had 2 on him, you've done more than 5 points over his armor.
Yep.
Which does double damage.
Just tell us what's going on, Justin.
Does double damage.
He's dead.
Yeah. He dead.
Has we won the game?
He did!
And so we gain 2 more XP.
Has we won the game?
Do we have to get out?
And trumpet's blaring. We win.
Yes!
Okay, so.
Take
game over.
That.
Time for my favourite part. It's time to divvy up the loot.
So much XP.
So, yeah, there's quite the bit of XP here. So we have 3 of us. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
God, what but, a, this is an exciting end here.
I am riveting right now.
Okay, so 7 each.
Yeah.
Now to go through our abilities for the next game. I'm excited.
I'm going to look around at them after this
and
is over.
There's 7 for you, Lance. And because I only got 6, I get a bonus XP to keep me up. So if we play this again, let's just mark this down on a note. And actually okay. just say, next time we come to play, we have 7
comment
XP.
Below to remind us.
Yeah, yeah. Well, just say, we'll say if we sit down to play this again, we have 7 XP to use on an ability or 2 for the next game. The other thing is, you could save them because some of these are actually quite expensive.
Yeah, I've got one here that's 12.
Yeah, I've got one here that's 16.
Right, come on. Stop talking and let me celebrate. We win!
And so our intrepid adventurers left the dungeon to return to the tavern to spend their winnings.
That's a good idea. Let's go to a pub and get a pint.
Let's. All right, guys. Drop your comments below. Hopefully you enjoyed that. We'll see you again soon.
Venture into the dangerous dungeons of Myth as a mighty hero and stand against the darkness. Visit the Myth Hub on beastofwar.com and begin your story. Fight for the Iron Kingdoms as a Warcaster. Take control of the mighty jacks, arcane devices, and dark sorceries to bring the fight to the War Machine Hub on beastofwar.com.